It's the NBA on 2K Sports. Hello, everyone. Great to have you with us. This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. It's the Chicago Bulls taking on. Now let's take a look at the Bulls opening lineup. And for the Pistons. And it's going to be the Bulls off the tip. Number 14, connects from three-point range.
Oh, he's going to keep banging those home if you give him that much space.
Detroit with the ball. It's a three-point game. To the inside. No block shot. There's the block. One-on-one here. Launches it. And the Bulls, another three.
No matter who it is, that kind of defense is not going to cut it.
On defense, the Bulls. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Kevin, thank you. I spoke with the Pistons head coach for just a bit. Their number one priority is not to give up any looks on the inside, anything easy in the interior, guys. He told me, quote, "We want to have the key look like a fancy club out there. Crowded, not a lot of room, and very hard to get into." Sounds like your kind of place, Kevin.
And thank you for that, Doris.
Looky here, looky here. How about that one? That play. Take that play and put it in the alley-oop textbook for future reference.
Perfectly done. He put it on a platter for him.
He sure did. And how about the touch on the finish, too? That was really nicely done.
Four on the clock. Number eight. They can't stop the run with that one. Left block shot on the way. Another one falls for Chicago.
Well, one of the things that makes him special is his tendency to become red hot in just a matter of seconds. And you never know when it's coming. You know, all it takes is a shot or two, and he's rolling.
And also, he catches a lot of defenders off balance, Steve, with his ability to pull up and drain shots off the bounce. It's a very effective skill to have.
And Detroit has possession. The Bulls getting the bucket. The Pistons need to get off a shot here. Off the mark and a bad shot there.
That's a bad shot. You really hurt your team by taking a shot from that range. You put your defense in jeopardy.
And it certainly won't make him any friends with his teammates.
Obvious foul.
Yeah, he took a hit right there and earned those free throws.
The Bulls shooting their first free throws of the game.
Well, you look back at a season ago, this is a club that made 78% of its shots from the free throw line, so very comfortable with that strike.
And, you know, that just added to their confidence at the offensive end. I mean, knowing that free throw shooting was something they didn't have to worry about gave them a lot of confidence to play freely.
And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Stolen away. And here we go, the Bulls fast break. Bulls moving the ball around. Gets an open look and hits. He's got six.
All these open threes they're giving up have really been the driving force of this run.
I agree, guys. And the points add up in a hurry when you start giving up easy looks from long range.
There's the pick. Clock at six. They need this. Shot denied. Here we go, one-on-one. Number 11. Great pass to set up the lay-in. And now we'll get perspective here on how the hustle game has been going for the Bulls.
But great hustle defensively through two quarters of play, contesting everything, starting to rack up those block shots, guys.
They also came out of the locker room with their running shoes on. I mean, their transition game has been full throttle.
So it's Detroit now after the Bulls pick up two. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play.
Well, it took a while, but somebody finally got a shot to go.
You know, I was starting to get a little concerned for them. I mean, it hadn't been pretty to this point.
And as hot as he's been this quarter, the game plan should be simple. Get him the ball and get out of the way.
Tipped. He lobs it up.
Their offense has really come together immediately, threatening to run away with this game.
It's hard to imagine they'll be able to stay as hot as they've been so far, but if they can, watch out.
There's 49 seconds left to play in the first. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Number 5. Off the left rim and out.
He doesn't really scare a defense at all. You've seen him miss quite a few just like those.
Shot's good. He's got 17.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last 4 buckets allowed have come from very close range.
And giving up these easy chances is going to do wonders for their confidence.
And so it's Detroit with the ball. Cannot hit. And he's going up for the alley-oop. And that's it for the first quarter in what's been a very lopsided. Welcome back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move here into the second. And guys, we've seen a confident-looking Bulls team out there.
Yeah, this team is on the same page, no question. They're right where they need to be offensively.
And they're hitting their scores with on-time and on-target passes, too. That's fun to watch.
On the court right now, second quarter for the Bulls.
Well, sometimes when you're at a height disadvantage, that's the way to attack. Go right at your defender.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Doris Burke.
Gentlemen, as you know, Kevin Durant is a real gym rat, a guy who just loves the game of basketball, and he enjoys studying the greats. Maybe his favorite? Durant smiled. Larry Bird is a guy I like watching. I watch film on him all the time. I like his approach to the game, his competitiveness, how low maintenance he was. He played hard. He played for the love of the game, and that's what I've got. Guy's one of the best small forwards in league history. Not a bad role model.
No doubt about that. Thank you, Doris. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
They got to find something, you're right. The Bulls making a switch here. Now a timeout called by Detroit.
He has to be concerned with all the missed shots. It happens to every team, but you have to find a way to keep being productive even when you go through a shooting drought.
He might be trying to tell them to get to the free throw line. You know, all teams go cold at points during the game, but the good teams still find ways to score.
And Detroit has possession.
Defensive foul. Number 14. That's his first personal foul. First team foul.
Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter. Six on the shot clock. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line. This trip is his second to the free throw line in this one.
Help out! Help out!
There's a good screen. But three. The Bulls keep it alive. Inside, number 4, and it's rejected. Number 8. Can't get it to go. And the Bulls going the other way now. We're now about 2 minutes into the second quarter. Got a piece of it. Number 14, and he uses the glass on the layup. 8 points for him. So it's Detroit now. We're just over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. All by himself. Makes the lead pass.
Boy, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition.
Number 10, and the powerful one-handed slam. Now, Clark, that is just ridiculous.
Absolutely filthy. Oh, I don't remember ever seeing a dunk like that in a game. I certainly can't remember the last time I saw one.
Oh, man, that was just amazing.
And the Pistons with possession here. Six to shoot. Number 7. And again, it's the Pistons missing. Throws it up high.
What a smooth finish.
Well, he's certainly the one they want on the end of those breaks. He always finishes strong.
And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played. And here we go, the Bulls fast break. And here they go. And the whistle blows as the basket counts in a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up.
Brought back the finger roll. That's a nice finesse move to pull off with the defense all over it.
The Bulls have gone 2 for 2 in the game at the line. And the Pistons, an entirely new group now out there.
He's jammed himself up a little bit here with that second foul. But as long as he can avoid a third before the half, I think he's fine.
The Bulls making a switch here. Bulls on D. Their defense has only allowed 4 points in the quarter. Number 12. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. The first one falls. So he gets them both. And the Bulls with possession. They're on a 14-4 run. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. And he's knocked off course by the D. The foul called. He'll shoot free throws. The Bulls have yet to miss from the free throw line. They're 3 for 3. The Pistons making a change here. Both good from the line that time. And Detroit has possession. 43 seconds left in the first half of the game. Number 13. No luck, and Chicago will go the other way with the ball. There's 21 seconds left in the first half of basketball. And good on the basket. Book it. He's got 21.
And now we can see them really working it inside.
Yeah, taking advantage of the defense, really pounding it down low.
Knocked loose. Number 14. And it is good at the buzzer. Wow.
Pretty shot.
Now, presented by Sprint. Damon Bruce, the Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And as we begin the second half, first half wasn't even close, guys, and we'll see if there is a comeback on our hands or more of the same as we get the third quarter started. The jump hook, tries again. Can't hit. Now Chicago takes it the other way. And for Chicago, number 11. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot. He's had 4 chances at the line, made them all. The first free throw is good. He hits both from the stripe. And for Detroit, releases from 15. No good on the shot, a bit long that time.
That's not how you want to kick off the second half with 3 straight misses.
And for the Bulls, lays it up and in on the nice reverse. He's got 25.
They've been so efficient in the paint in this game. That's an area they've totally dominated.
You know, once they ID'd the edge they had inside, they just continued to attack it.
There's the pick. Five to shoot. Number five. And it's Chicago with the rebound.
Starting to get restless here. 0 for 4 to start the second half.
Number 14 hits it from three-point range. He's got 13.
Well, as they continue to dominate, you wonder just how much higher this lead might get.
I think it really could get out of hand, and you can credit their defense just as much as their offense for that.
To halt the run, and he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
Finally get one to drop after starting the half with four straight clanks.
Goes up the baseline. Number 11. And the defense didn't have position. They whistle a blocking foul, and he'll go to the line. He's made all six of his tries at the line so far. Good on both. 2 minutes gone in this third quarter now. Number 8. No good. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. Number 7. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Well, because of his passing ability, Kevin, I mean, if you're going to play with him, your only job is to get open on the floor, because he will get you the ball, and he'll give it to you in rhythm so that you can get a good shot off.
And he is also a very savvy on-the-ball defender. He'll turn a crossover into a turnover if you try it against him.
Pistons passing it around. Shot clock at 6. Number 5. Again, the miss by the Pistons.
He's one guy the defense is not afraid to leave open from that range, and for obvious reasons.
Number 11. Number 14. Sinks the three-pointer. 16 points for him.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Number 4. He lobs up the alley-oop pass, throws down the alley-oop slam.
A little bit of a magic act here, pulling off the Houdini to make that catch and slam.
Stupendous, stupendous alley-oop.
This crowd just stunned at the sight of that one.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. Blocked. Tries to keep it alive. And here we go, the Bulls fast break. From downtown, and the Bulls another 3.
Boy, his performance from long range has been incredible.
I know that was your shot, Steve, and today it's his too.
There's 57 seconds left in the third quarter. Number 8. So the whistle blows on the shot, and 2 free throws for the contact right there. The Pistons shooting their 6th and 7th free throws in the game. And the first one at the line is good. And the Bulls making a change here. And good on the second, so he makes them both. 44 seconds left in the third. Number 5. Kept alive. Number 10. Soft touch off the glass. 8 points for him.
Giving them an opportunity at second chance points with some hard work on the glass there.
Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. The Pistons have gone 5 of 7 from the free throw line in the game.
At the line for two.
That free throw, no good. Bulls making a switch here. And he can't make the second free throw either, missing both. The tray that misses would have counted had it gone in. The three quarters of play all in the books, and this one all but over. Welcome back as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. Not exactly a nail biter here, but you never know. And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Bulls.
Boy, their passing has been picturesque, a thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
And another thing they're doing is really taking advantage of fast break opportunities, scoring some easy baskets.
Okay, now let's reset our lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this fourth quarter. On the court for the Pistons, Detroit with the ball. Number 14. Wide open, couldn't capitalize. Time called here, the Bulls decide. And the Bulls making a change here. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. He has 29.
You know, something we're seeing less and less of these days, that little finger roll.
60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth. Number 9. It's hauled in by the Bulls. To the middle. Deflects the pass. And now the Pistons fast break. Number 12. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Well, at least the defender got his money's worth on that one.
Yep, that was an easy whistle for the official.
The Pistons making a change here. That's also good. So he hits both free throws. So it's Chicago now. Number 11. The shot misses. And the Pistons now going the other way. About a minute and a half into the fourth quarter now. Number 13. The Pistons rebound. Got a piece of it. And out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. And the Pistons making a change here.
Number 4.
Poked away. Number 9. And he's good on the three ball. There's the lob to the hoop.
Excellent communication between teammates on the alley-oop there.
And that's what you need to pull that off.
Well, both ends of that play, just fantastic.
And the Pistons with possession. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Pistons will retain possession. The Bulls making a switch here. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. Six to shoot. dives for it. It's out of bounds. The Pistons able to retain possession here.
5 seconds on the shot clock. Five.
And so it's Detroit with the ball. Number 10. And that is good. Picked him clean. We're in the final quarter of play here. 3 minutes in. They get a hand on it. And here we go. The Bulls. Fast break.
Well, that's a wrap, fellas. No way you come back in this one.
Not anymore. Any chance of that happening went out the window a while ago.
1:52 left in the fourth. And here we go. The Bulls. Fast break.
How about that nice 1-2 punch there, guys? Great defensive play, and of course, it leads to the great basket in transition.
Love the attacking style there, Steve.
1:41 left to play in the final quarter. Guys, we've seen a lot of turnovers in this one.
Yeah, it's been really sloppy out there.
I understand that they're trying to be aggressive, but still, I mean, you can play fast, but still play efficiently, but they're not doing that right now.
Their rebounding has been off the charts today, guys. Reason number one, this game is out of hand.
Exactly. I mean, the score is right where you'd expect it to be when the battle on the boards is that lopsided.
Six on the shot clock. Gets it to go. He's got 31.
You know, they've been so effective when they've been able to get the ball inside.
Some real shortcomings from this defense. I mean, they've given up 5 straight looks in the paint.
Pistons passing it around. 56 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
That foul gives him 4, so he's just 2 away from being Dairy Queen.
And the Bulls making a change here. There's 49 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Clock at 6. The shot. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. It's stolen.
Yeah, no way you can come back from this deficit.
Just not enough time left on the clock.
3-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Number 4. The feather touch on the finger roll. Beautiful.
Boy, they're extending their lead. It kind of feels like they're just piling on here as we come to an end.
Well, hey, let's just call it what it is. They are trying to run it up on them.
Got a piece of it. And so Chicago takes this one and by a big margin. Some days, Clark, everything goes right for a team, and they just hit one of those games.
Yeah, it certainly was. I mean, these guys played a great all-around basketball game here.
For Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in. Now it's time to present our Jordan Player of the Game.